More than 90 cities all over the US have committed to run on 100% renewable energy. We're talking wind, solar, hydropower, geothermal, and more. This is an exciting trend when you consider that 70% of our carbon emissions in the US come from cities. If more cities were to make the switch, we could have a real impact on our climate goals. So, how does a city transition to 100% renewable energy? To find out, I'm in St. Petersburg, Florida, to talk to the mayor and learn how a bunch of volunteers convinced their city to go 100% renewable. And I connect with activists in New York as they lobby their representatives to commit to a 100% renewable agenda. I'm Lucy Biggers, and this is One Small Step. Renewable energy is an energy made from natural processes that don't run out, like wind or solar. In contrast, there are a limited amount of fossil fuels like oil and coal that exist on Earth. Fossil fuels also produce greenhouse gases like CO2 and methane, while renewable energy has an almost non-existent carbon footprint. There are great benefits to switching your city to 100% renewable energy. It's clean, so you're reducing air pollution and cutting CO2 emissions. Not to mention, the investment in infrastructure creates new jobs. In Florida itself, they created nearly 2,000 new solar jobs in 2018. Right now, 6 U.S. cities run on 100% renewable energy. Places like Aspen, Colorado, Burlington, Vermont, and Georgetown, Texas have all made the transition and hit their targets. What's so cool is the list includes red and blue cities, so this is not a partisan issue. Today, I'm in St. Petersburg, Florida, where in 2016, a group of activists successfully convinced their city leaders to commit to transition their city to 100% renewable energy. James Scott was one of the leading advocates of that movement. So what would be your advice to organizers or just regular old people in other communities who maybe want to see something like this pass in their town?
One of the first steps is to identify people who share your values, people kind of in your community who are likely allies. You kind of got to build an alliance, even having like a round table at your house.
Wow.
Just inviting people in your community to begin that conversation and say, okay, where do we start, guys? Mm-hmm. You know, who do we begin this conversation with? Find your local Sierra Club group, connect with your local leaders in the Sierra Club. I help co-author a toolkit for organizing.
Amazing. Really,
there's an actual booklet. And it'll tell you, okay, how to get started, how to start writing editorials, identifying targets in your city council and your community, and literally it's all there, and kind of walks you through how to build that momentum mm-hmm. and how to ultimately get your city government behind your goal.
If you're in a community and you're trying to get this movement started, how much time commitment is this? How much money do you have to spend to really get something like this off the ground?
Theoretically, you can do this for free. You contact your mayor, you contact your mayor's office, your city council person. Those things are free.
In 2016, the activists accomplished their goal. Mayor Kreisman announced that St. Petersburg would be the first city in the state of Florida to commit to transitioning to 100% renewable energy. What motivated you to make renewable energy a priority of your city?
In St. Pete, we have 361 days of sunshine. And so when I became mayor, our city was really, I don't mean to use the pun, underwater, but we kind of were. We hadn't done anything to start getting our city ready for what we are already experiencing with sea level rise mm-hmm. and climate change. And so from executive orders to hiring a director of sustainability to getting the entire community involved in creating an integrated sustainability action plan, that's really kind of what we've been doing since I became mayor, to start getting the city ready for what we've got to deal with. I've had some people say, well, you're just one city. We all have to say, what can we do to make a difference? What can we do to impact climate? How do we mitigate our impact and reduce our carbon footprint? You know, your community will get behind you. This community is really behind our efforts.
And on top of the environmental benefits, have there been other benefits that you hadn't foreseen?
Yeah, that's the thing that I think a lot of people are missing, that piece of it, is what a great way of creating jobs, of creating a whole new economy. Mm-hmm. I mean, whether it's the people who are doing the installation of solar panels or it's those who are doing the research on the technologies for batteries.
And do you have a timeline on when you want to get to 100%?
Yes. Our goal is to be at 100% by 2035. And then we're also working on our greenhouse gas emissions. We want to reduce them by 80% by 2050. I don't know if it's a small step or it's a big leap, but it's just taking action, not being afraid, not saying, you know, I'm not going to make a difference. Start working on a plan.
Mayor Kreisman, thank you so much for having me. I'm so inspired by being in St. Petersburg and seeing all that you're doing, and I hope that you're going to be an example to the rest of the country because we need even more action like this.
It's so important. You know, this is the future of our planet. For those of us who have kids, what are we leaving them?
Since committing to renewable energy, the city has made it easier for residents to get loans for solar panels and energy efficiency projects, as well as paid for rooftop solar installations on government properties, new electric car charging stations, and solar-powered bike share stations throughout the city. The next benchmark on their path to 100 is a citywide 20% reduction in greenhouse gas emissions by 2020. It's great to see that cities like St. Petersburg are committed to renewables, but what about the state level? Today, I'm in Albany, New York, where organizers are lobbying state legislatures to make the transition.
Daniela, thank you so much for being here with me today and telling me about your work. So what is the CCPA?
Yeah, so the Climate and Community Protection Act would be the most ambitious, most progressive legislation on climate in the country.
Wow.
It truly combines the values of climate, jobs, and justice. So the CCPA would get New York off fossil fuels economy-wide. Mm-hmm. It would make sure that green jobs that we create have fair labor standards. And it would make sure that we're investing money and resources directly into communities that have been most impacted by climate change and pollution. We would be the first state to set a legally binding mandate to get the whole of New York's economy off fossil fuels.
Okay.
It's not just electricity. It's about transportation. It's about how we heat and cool our buildings. Because electricity, going 100% renewable is a really great step.
Yeah.
But for New York, it only represents 20% of emissions.
Got it.
So the CCPA would take New York economy-wide off of fossil fuels.
And why do this at the state level versus a local level?
Energy systems are really complicated and usually operate on a statewide basis. So
right.
We need a big framework on the state level to say we're all working toward the same goal
right.
of a climate justice platform for New York State.
In June 2019, a version of the CCPA passed the New York State Senate. The Climate Leadership and Community Protection Act mandates by the year 2050 a statewide greenhouse gas reduction of 85% and a carbon neutral economy. The bill is the strongest state-level emissions regulation in the country and will begin to go into effect before the end of the year.
It is so amazing to see that cities running on 100% renewable energy aren't an abstraction. And I hope from watching this video, you understand this is totally possible in your community. Find like-minded people and contact your city council or your mayor. Just start there, because we need more cities transitioning to 100% renewable energy if we're gonna fight climate change.
That's all for this week's episode of One Small Step. Thank you so much for watching. If you liked it, please hit subscribe and we'll see you next time.